My best friend of 12 years has been cheating on her fiance with an old friend of ours from college. She shares all sorts of intimate details about their lovemaking, including that her friend is a closeted crossdresser. I've never been that close to her fiance, but this whole situation makes me feel uncomfortable. What should I do?
Who cares? Does it affect you in any way?
Well, no, it doesn't affect me. But then when I drive by and see a gruesome car accident with the guy's guts strewn all over the pavement, blood splurting all over, that doesn't affect me either. My friend is boning another guy behind her fiancé's back with high-speed Kama Sutra tricks, according to her.
Life is about choices, and she made hers. Personally, when I make my choice, I pick the one alternative that gives me the most attention, when I want it, and the freedom to go wherever it suits me, and to give myself as much pleasure as I can get. Maybe your friend thinks doing both guys at the same time takes care of her needs. So what's wrong with that?
Okay, let me get this straight. If my friend wants to screw a navy fleet of guys behind her fiancé's back, that's her business and I should congratulate her on her freedoms and seeking to maximize her pleasure.
Exactly. But there is an important thing I left out.
Well, geesh, golly, gosh, please tell me already, you pin-headed cat.
A feline must always make sure each guy thinks they are the only one she loves. It takes careful preparation. In my opinion, only cats know how to pull this off. They have been taking advantage of everyone long before man was walking on two legs. Any human can do this with a little practice. Taking advantage of people is what makes life worth living. That's from a cat's perspective, and it's the only one that matters in this world.
So your message is I should not hesitate to play around behind my girlfriend or my fiancé or my wife, if I want to, and make sure she will never know. That gives me so much freedom. This is a total release from society's norms and mores. Wow, what great advice. I think getting advice from a feline is amazing. What perspective and insight.
Cat principle number one, if she's not into your cat chow, why should you be in hers? She taking advantage of her situation, and that's always good. Live and let live, I say.